From Jerusalem by the Israeli Prime Minister's spokesman, Mark Regev. Mark Regev, the operation that you're engaged in is Protective Edge, and its stated purpose is to protect Israeli civilians. How does killing children on a beach contribute to that purpose?
Well, it doesn't. The truth is, this is Hamas's decision for shooting at us from these urban areas. That is a war crime. They should not be doing that, and they should be condemned for it, and I trust you'll condemn them for doing it.
Well, it's the United Nations. It's the United Nations
hospitals.
Who have questioned whether what you're doing is perhaps a war crime. There are grave uncertainties about whether you're acting within the law.
Oh, yes.
3 days ago, the United Nations questioned very urgently whether it was Nadia Pillay who actually raised this question of whether you are, in fact, targeting people and committing a war crime thereby. It's in the air.
What's your message to the people of Palestine?
They should know. We feel very shame what's going on there, especially they're doing everything in our name, in the name of Jews, in the name of the Torah, in the name of God. It's so shameful. We are with you. You have to know. The Zionists are strong. We are weak. But God is on our side. At the end of the day, the Palestinian flag will be on all Palestine, from the river to the sea.
I'm tired of seeing comments like, save Israel. From what? Minmeva? Are you... Are you okay? Save you from what? Rocks? Your country is literally trying so hard to become real that it literally named itself Israel. We know it isn't. Go steal some of the land.
What is the biggest waste of money?
Okay, this so much. Like, people need to understand it is not the evil Jews driving Zionist foreign policy. The United States loves Israel so much because of evangelical Christians. The biggest supporters of AIPAC are evangelicals. And why is this? It's because evangelicals believe that if all Jews return to Israel, this will trigger revelations. The ideological grounding of Zionism in the Americas is about end times Christianity. It's about using Jews as a token to achieve an evangelical Christian prophecy. Get it right.
Don't know what's inside of me. Don't forget about me. Don't forget about me. Even when
people started supporting Palestine, which is basically equivalent to black people supporting police.
Yeah, right, let's compare and promote undermining of movements against injustice, and let's support Israel who steals land, kills, harasses and rapes innocent people and families regardless their race, gender, age, religion or sexuality. Let's also not forget the fact that USA sells military equipment to Israel while they kill innocent children and defend themselves against innocent citizens who are not a threat whatsoever. Oh, and on top of that, same-sex marriages are not legal in Israel. Why would you attack a mosque during a holy month and then celebrate it? Why would you kick out people from their houses if they were the ones to welcome you when you had nowhere to go? If you are for basic human rights, then you should support Palestine. Free Palestine till it's backwards.
I didn't realize this had to be said, but as a queer person, bombing children is not actually the appropriate response to homophobic violence.
There is a clear oppressor and a clear group of people being oppressed. I don't understand how this is controversial. How is this humane? How are you still silent?
Standing the bitch deaf dumb. You ain't my son, you my motherfucking stepson.
Salvation and I fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home.
Ibrahim, Yahya, Lina, Mustafa, Bashar, Ibrahim, Muhammad, Hussein, Bara, Rahat, Marwan, Hamza, Hala, Zaid, Ammar, Hamada, Khalid, Lina, Bethana, Amir, Adam, Muhammad, Ismail, Ahmad, Muhammad, Hur, Ibrahim, Fawziya, Islam, Ambar, Muhammad, Abdullah, Suhaib, Abdulrahman, Usam.
So I saw this on TikTok and I wanted to do it myself. This is Snapchat's public map where live stories from every city is posted. So let's see what's going on in Tel Aviv. Horses, looks like it's having fun. Driving around the city, having fun, smoking. Looks pretty good to me, going on trips. Listening to music, walking around, going to the beach, having family dinner in a warm home, going to Starbucks, going to the beach, drinking, having fun. Okay, all right, let's go to Gaza. Look what's going on in Gaza. Do you see anyone having fun, going to the beach? They're fighting for their lives. Look how crazy, you guys.
Hey! If you come near me again, I'm gonna break your face! No, no, bro, you keep coming in at the wrong time. He punched me!
Breaking news! A Palestinian man incites violence and threatens to kill an innocent Israeli man.
Headshot! Headshot! I got a headshot! What now, huh? They got guns. I got rocks. There's no way you can make me look bad.
This just in, Palestinians have received a large shipment of extremely dangerous rocks and pebbles, possibly from Iran. In the meantime, we have tried reaching out to the United Nations for a statement regarding this violence. Unfortunately, they seem to be quite busy.
They literally can no longer deal with the tunnel vision of these Zionists being all, I see you condemning Israel, but I don't see you condemning Hamas. What do you have to say about Hamas? Okay, Captain America, where were you when Israel was shooting and bombing the Palestinians praying at Al-Aqsa, injuring more than 600 Palestinians? This started way before Gaza. Don't even. If you have like this weird fetish for apartheid and ethnic cleansing, then just say it, my guy. Admit it, you know, do you?
I'm at one, and I've been quiet for too long.
It says free Palestine.
Fuck you and fuck your mother.
Fucking Kim Jong-un, kill everyone.
I change time, time, change time.
Free Palestine.
If
free Palestine,
Israel,
and I'm not Ching Chang Chong.
I'll Ching Chang 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 Chang.
There's free Palestine.
I like eating dogs. Free Corona, you son of a bitch.
Astaghfirullah. May Allah guide you on the right path.
I'm a cax.
Hello?
Hello, China. Fair model. Ching Ching Chong Ching Chong.
Free Palestine.
Kim Jong Un, Kim Jong Un.
This is China, China.
Free Palestine.
Hey, fuck you, your Venezuela.
Free Palestine.
Fuck you, mom, dead.
Free
Israel. Wallah, Israel.
And I don't mind if I lose any blood on the way to salvation. And I fight with the strength that I got until I die. So I'm gonna stand up, take my people with me. Together we are going to a brand new home far across.
Well, if blacks in the United States excluded from roughly 90% of the territory by a variety of laws and administrative procedures, I would call it white supremacy. That's the way Israel has been since its origins. If there were large-scale funding in the United States for white settlements, development of white areas, but nothing for black settlements and black areas, I'd call it white supremacy. It's not the case that even within Israel's own boundaries, Jews and Palestinians are treated equally. You can't even have Israeli citizenship. And if you're Palestinian, you're deprived of many rights in all sorts of ways. That's a form of Jewish supremacy, just as it would be white.
So what brings you here today to support Palestinian rights? We as Jews are embarrassed what's happening there in the state of Israel in the Jewish name.
And what's your message to the people of Palestine?
They shouldn't give up the struggle. They should continue to fight and not give up the struggle against the state of Israel, because by the end, Palestine will be free, because this is truth. And the truth, which are free Palestine, will succeed by the end.
The bravest people on earth right now are Palestinians. They're standing up against armed soldiers with nothing but rocks and a big heart, while the rest of the world just watches in silence. You don't need to be Arab, you don't need to be Muslim, you don't even need to be Palestinian to stand up for what's going on in Palestine. All you need to be is a decent human being. Now, people might say sharing a few videos or posting a few stories isn't gonna free Palestine. Now, that's where you're wrong. We need to keep spreading this information and bringing light to the injustices that's going on in Palestine so more people know about it. The more people know about it, the more pressure it puts on the world to bring change to what's going on. Inshallah, Palestine will be free.